All right, last method we're going to talk about is the aging of receivables method. And this one, like I said, is a little bit more detailed. It gives us a little bit more accuracy because it breaks things down more. So let's get into the verbiage of it, and then I'll show you an example of it. So what this does is it uses both past and current receivables information to estimate the allowance amount. So in the past two methods that we talked about, we just assume everything is the same. If somebody owes us money, they're all the same. But we know that's not always the case, because if somebody's still current, I have a higher likelihood of them actually paying than somebody that's 4 months overdue. If they're 4 months overdue, the likelihood of them paying is slim to none. So when I'm able to put them into categories, I can change the percentages to make them a little bit more accurate. So that's what we're doing here. Each receivable is classified by how long it has passed its due date. Okay, and an estimated percentage of uncollectibles is then assigned to each classification. So each one has their own respective percentage, and then totaled to get the allowance for doubtful account balance. Again, this one is telling us the end result is the allowance for doubtful account balance. So we need to subtract that from what we already had in there to figure out what we need to put in there in the adjusting entry. So let's look at an example of an aging schedule. This is what you would see. So customer A through D shows what their total amount is. And as you can tell, customer A, 5,000. So their entire amount is actually still current. But like customer B, they have 10,000 in total. 5,000 is 1 month overdue and 5,000 is 2 month overdue. And then customer C is they have part of theirs is current, but then they have some that's 3 months overdue. And then customer D is past 3 months overdue. So the likelihood of them paying is actually slim to none. So then I total out each of those columns, and then each of those categories has their own percentage of uncollectibles. So the current one, the one that I have the most likelihood of getting back, I'm only probably going to consider them about 2% to be uncollectible. I have a 2% chance of me not getting those. But 1 month past that, or 1 month past due, I'm probably looking at 5%. And then 2 months, 10%. And 3 months, 25%. And if I'm getting up to 4 months or more, I'm a 50-50 chance they're going to pay or they're not. And so then I would multiply those percentages by the categories, classifications, totals. And then once I have those, add them all up, and that's where you would get the 3,400. And that would be my ending balance for my aging of receivables method. So that would be my ending balance of the allowance for doubtful accounts. And so that's how you do an aging method. So again, you'll find the example here in the next video that'll make things a little bit more clear.